This e-presentation will introduce you to the theory of planned behaviour. This evolved out of the theory of reasoned action, which states that intentions are the best predictor of behaviour. The main premise of this is that if we plan to do something, then we are more likely to do it. According to the theory of planned behaviour, intentions are the product of three different processes: behavioural attitudes, subjective norms, and perceived behavioural control. By the end of the presentation, you will hopefully understand the different predictors of intentions according to the theory of planned behaviour. We will also apply a real-life example to the theory, helping you to recognise how this might be used in a day-to-day scenario. According to the theory, the first predictor of intentions are behavioural attitudes. This relates to how a person thinks and feels about the behaviour and reflects their expectations and evaluations of the behaviour. This can be split into two different aspects: effective attitude and instrumental attitude. What do we mean by effective attitude? Well, this could be whether a person believes the behaviour to be enjoyable or unenjoyable. In an exercise situation, this might be the extent to which a person enjoys going for a run. Whereas instrumental attitude refers to whether the behaviour is believed to be beneficial or harmful. These are not always clear-cut, and an individual might have a mixture of effective and instrumental attitudes. The second predictor of intentions is subjective norms, which relates to the support given or not given by family, friends, or significant others, such as a GP. Similar to attitudes, this can be split into two different types: injunctive or descriptive. Injunctive norms refer to whether others encourage an individual to do the behaviour, and descriptive norms relate to whether others in a person's social group engage or don't engage in the same behaviour. The third and final predictor of intentions, and an additional contribution of the theory of planned behaviour, is perceived behavioural control. In sport and exercise psychology, control is an important variable. Within the theory of planned behaviour, the extent to which a person feels capable and has confidence in their ability to execute the desired behaviour will play a central role in their intentions and actual behavioural outcomes. This could be likened to the perception that a person has the capabilities to overcome potential barriers and challenges. Let's consider the theory as a whole. It states that when a person perceives an activity as enjoyable, with good benefits, where they have the support and encouragement of others, as well as members of their social group that already engage in the behaviour, and ultimately feel that they have the ability to meet the demands of the task, they will form stronger intentions and be more likely to engage in the activity. As we consider what we have just looked at, let's bring in the example of Sharon. Sharon does not enjoy exercise, which reflects her effective attitude, but she knows that there are benefits for her health. She has also acknowledged the risks associated with not engaging in exercise, such as the likelihood of having a heart attack. This reflects an ambivalence regarding her instrumental attitude. In this instance, these attitudes are unlikely to promote strong intentions. As we learn more about Sharon, we see that her doctor and her husband are encouraging her to engage in physical activity, which should improve her health. This represents the injunctive norms we discussed earlier. However, neither her husband nor her close friends engage in exercise. Thus, this is likely to reduce the impact of social norms on her intentions, even though she appreciates the opinions of her doctor, husband, and friends. Sharon also has low perceptions of behavioural control, with little confidence in her ability to exercise and feels exhausted. This is likely to serve as a barrier for her, at least initially, as well as the fact that she has concerns about displaying her body in public. On a positive note, the exercise classes take place in the local neighbourhood. They are free and can be fitted in and around work, which should encourage a sense of control. Overall, Sharon's intentions to attend the exercise classes are likely to be weak, but positive. Try and develop your own scenarios and then apply the theory of planned behaviour to them. Create a fictional character and try to develop a story that would distinguish between a person who is likely to develop weak, moderate, and strong intentions to engage in an exercise class.